Man, this is such a fun guitar to play. I'm Dagan from PMTVUK, and this is the Jarrah James Nichols signature Epiphone Old Glory. In my opinion, Mr. Jarrah James Nichols is one of the best things to happen to the guitar world in a very long time. He's a breath of fresh air and brings raw passion and energy for this instrument back into the mainstream. Not that it was cluttered with lots of math metal and how fast and intricate can you play, and if you can't do this then you're not a good guitar player. That's not really the case, but it was certainly leaning towards that way, and as soon as Jarrah came along without his plectrum and only one P90 pickup, he proceeded to then blow everybody's minds. He's one of the best guitar players on the planet, and I've had the pleasure of meeting him on a number of occasions. I was one of the first people to ever interview him in the UK, and he's as humble then as he is now. Great guy, and very deserving of a signature Les Paul guitar. Speaking of said guitar, this has been out for a little while now, and I don't know why I haven't done a full review at PMTVUK on this guitar before. I actually own one. It's the one with gold hardware, so if you see one on PMT's channels, an Old Glory with gold hardware, it's just mine. I've changed it because I'm tacky like that. It comes with beautiful nickel hardware though, and they've just released a gold variant, the Gold Glory. Hopefully I'll get my hands on that very soon and show you guys, but spec-wise, they're pretty much the same. In fact, let's get into the specs. As you can see, it's based off a 1955 Les Paul Custom, a guitar Jarrah was mostly associated with before he got his signature Old Glory. That guitar was known as Old Glory, hence the name, and I'll talk about that a bit more in a second. Spec-wise on the signature though, mahogany body as you'd expect with a beautiful satin finish. It's kind of like an aged tuxedo Les Paul Custom. It's not shiny, it's not super matte, it's just kind of beautifully aged and unfortunately shows up lots of fingerprints. But it's cool, it's part of the vibe I guess. You've got 7-ply white binding on the front and 5-ply white binding on the back. A set mahogany neck, and it's a 1950s profile mahogany neck. So it's a chunky boy, just as Jarrah likes it and just as traditional vintage Les Paul Custom players love their necks. Bound all over the fingerboard, ebony fingerboard with the block inlays, but as you'll notice, they don't go past the 15th fret. I asked Jarrah this, and that's because he wanted to keep the Les Paul shape kind of there and very prominent, and once you start putting mother of pearl here, it kind of takes away from it a little bit and just kind of makes it look a bit sleeker. The glorious satin black finish is continued all the way up the neck, so it's super smooth and silky under your palm, just as smooth as it is under your fingertips. But on the back of the headstock with those Grover tuners, you will find a stinger. One of the coolest things to happen to Gibson guitars is a contrasting big stinger that goes all the way down to the first couple of frets. I think it looks cooler than just having a plain headstock. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. Staying with the headstock, it features that beautiful split diamond custom shop inlay surrounded by 5-ply binding. Moving down the fingerboard, 12-inch radius ebony fingerboard, so it's quite flat, very vintage Gibson inspired, perfect for playing blues power on, and 22 medium jumbo frets. Electronics wise, there's not a lot going on, but you can do a lot with Old Glory. She's a versatile bugger. One volume control and one tone control. These guys are great quality too. Jarrah uses the controls a lot, so he wanted great quality ones in his signature guitar so they didn't wear out. And they control that beautiful Seymour Duncan P90. Yep, a proper Seymour Duncan P90 in Old Glory, exactly the same as Jarrah's. Now, if you're still looking at Old Glory thinking, I know there's a pickup missing and I know there's less controls than there should be and the inlays don't go past the 15th fret, but something still doesn't look right, that's because it features a single wraparound tailpiece at the bridge, as opposed to the more traditional Les Paul tunematic bridge and stop bar tailpiece. This is cool for a number of reasons. The first one is the fact that it looks vintage as hell and absolutely awesome. The second being the fact that there's a more direct contact between the resonance of the strings and the body itself. There's no excess metal, so this thing sustains like nothing else and has a beautiful low-end robustness to it, which is perfect for getting your blues power on. The only downside to these bridges in the past was the fact that you couldn't really intonate it 100% because there wasn't a lot of adjustability at the bridge, if not none. However, Epiphone and Jarrah have found a way to fix this. They've added a compensated lightning bolt bridge to this guitar, so there's a kind of a lightning bolt design, keeping the strings a bit more separated, I'm going to say, to make it intonate a bit better. And there's also two little grub screws down the bottom to help with intonation too. Now let's hear it some more. I think that's all the specs on the Epiphone Jarrah James Nichols Old Glory Les Paul Custom by Epiphone. Such an amazing guitar, it just sings at you. I'm using TuaTech cables into the Blackstar HD Stage 100 watt Mark II head and cab. Jared is a longtime Blackstar user and has his own signature combo and 20-watt head and cab available. Get over to pmtonline.co.uk and check those out and watch my review on our channel. But I was going to tell you the history of Old Glory, wasn't I? It's very quick, but if you want to skip it, click the timestamps down in the description box down below. Essentially, Old Glory is a custom shop, 55 Les Paul Custom. And all I've got to say about it has the exact same specs as this guy. It might be nitrocellulose finish, Seymour Duncan pickup, mahogany body, 55 look, 50s profile neck, ebony board, medium jumbo frets. The original Old Glory by Gibson is a very fancy custom shop one. And I think Jared plays this more than he does that original one. That's how close this is, and it's not a lot of money. Oh, and it also comes with a Epiphone Epilite hard soft case, and a certificate of authenticity with Jared's lovely face and signature in it. That's all the talk I'm going to do. This is Old Glory. It's a brand new guitar, so the plastic is under the plastic from the pickup gets caught under the strings. Pickup, no problem. Just roll the tone control down to get that kind of American woman kind of vibe. Let's hear some cleans on this amplifier, because Jared always just rolls the volume down on his guitar, but you probably want to hear the clean channel of an amplifier, don't you? So that, ladies and gentlemen, was the Epiphone Jared James Nichols signature Les Paul Custom Old Glory. And I forgot to mention, instead of it saying Old Glory here like the original one does, it says Blues Power. And the reason this plate is here was originally on old 335s, or the original Old Glory, which came with a tunematic bridge and stop bar tailpiece. It hides the holes. Hides the holes of the original bridge when you put a Bigsby on a Les Paul or a 335. This plate used to say custom made, as it does on the Old Glory. And on his signature, it says Blues Power. Jarrett James Nichols' mantra, and it's an amazing guitar for an amazing player. Seriously, if you haven't tried one of these guitars, they're utterly fantastic. It's the closest thing you can get to a proper vintage custom instrument. It's remarkable. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on the Epiphone Jarrett James Nichols' signature Old Glory Les Paul Custom, get your fine self to PMTonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever-expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.